Stephen Sondheim, American composer and lyricist known for his contributions to musical theater. His most famous works include, as composer and lyricist, A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Forum, Company, Follies, A Little Night Music, Sweeney Todd, Sunday in the Park with George, and Into the Woods. He also wrote lyrics for Gypsy and West Side Story. A Funny Thing Happened on the Way to the Forum debuted in 1962. It was Sondheim's third Broadway production, but his first opportunity to be both composer and lyricist. The Laugh Out Loud show won 6 Tony Awards, and Forum ran for 964 performances, longer than any other Broadway production by Sondheim. In great contrast, Sondheim's musical A Little Night Music challenges the audience with more than a high kick and a happy ending. As the character, Desirée, sings Send in the Clowns, one of Sondheim's most famous songs. At the climactic moment of her story, when she's left just completely self-aware of her own circumstance, what she's lost, and what she never really had, she sings a simple song. The song is a collection of short, decaying phrases.
Isn't it rich? Are we a pair? Me here at last on the ground, you
a music of complete vulnerability and tenderness, where the gaps between each phrase of the melody, the silence, are as important as the notes themselves. In this song, like many of Sondheim's songs, highlights his desire to create drama in music. A song is not just a song. A melody is not just a melody. They're the soul of the character laid bare. Whenever I listen to Sondheim's music, the word that keeps coming to my mind is humanity. Sondheim seemed to not only understand the good things about people, but also the bad. There's no patronizing going on here, no sugarcoating, no blanket optimism. Sondheim's view of life and the world presents people as flawed, difficult, at times wrong. But his songs also tell us that we can be good, and that we can change. It's a view on life that I find deeply comforting. To be human is to be messy and complex. But it's also to note that we live in all that mess and complexity together, and that we are never alone. Stephen Sondheim may have been one of the greatest composer lyricists the theater's ever known, but he often said that he would have loved to have been a teacher. And well, I think he was.
I've said repeatedly that I believe that teaching is a sacred profession and that art is a form of teaching.